Good morning, dear students. Hope all of you are fine. Today is our first online class as it is not possible to take a regular class because of the present condition. So we are forced to take class through online. So I am going to teach the first lesson of social. Our first lesson is about early human life. Moving to the first topic. First of all, I will show you a picture. Can you see this picture? Can you say what did you understand from this pic? This picture is about the early humans, isn't it? Then the early humans using stones as weapons, isn't it? You know that the early humans live in the forest, or so they must use stones as weapons against the wild animals for their safety. So this period, that is, the men began to use the stones for the different purpose. This age is known as the stone. Now we can broadly divide the stone age or early human life into three. First one is Paleolithic age. Second one is Mesolithic age. Third one is Neolithic age. The early human life or the Stone Age is divided into mainly three. First one is Paleolithic Age, second one is Mesolithic Age, third one is Neolithic Age. Now we can move to our topic in detail. First one is Paleolithic Age. We know that early humans lived in caves. The information that we receive from the cave paintings gave a lot of information about the Paleolithic age. These cave paintings are drawn about 10,000 years ago. Look at these pictures. Dear students, can you see these pictures? These pictures are most important among the cave paintings. Actually, early human men hunted animals, isn't it? That is mainly for food or eating purpose. Then this is a picture of a group dance, isn't it? From this picture, we can understand that the Paleolithic men's main leisure was group activities. Okay, then they always like to be in a group or to work being in a group. Next picture is a depicting about a boar. Can you see this? Boar. What is boar? You know what is boar? Which means wild pig. Boar means wild pig. Kattabani. Okay, then the another is a special among the cave paintings, isn't it? Because the men used special colors and paints for this drawing. The colors were made from mixture of plant extracts and the powdered latrite. Okay. Then what informations did we get from these cave paintings? First one is they hunted animals. Okay, then next one is they collectively engaged in recreational activities. And next point is they observe the movement of animals and they lived intermingled with animals. And last point is they knew that art of painting. These are the informations that from the cave paintings. Okay, first one is they hunted animals. They collectively engaged in recreational activities and they observed the movement of animals. Then they lived with intermingled animals. And last one is they knew the art of paintings. The early humans draw different figures of animals like horse, bear, lion, leopard, deer, bison, etc. These are the pictures they draw in caves. Can you see this? The another important point is the animal fat were used as fuels for lightning because they lived in the caves, isn't it? They lived in the caves and inside of these caves the sunlight was very insufficient. So this animal fat was essential for them. Okay. The animal fat were used as fuel for lightening the caves. The cave paintings also. The cave paintings are a source of information about the early humans. Many other things discovered from these caves, such as cooked food. Many other things discovered from these caves, like residue of cooked food, ash, bones and skulls of animals, leftovers of fruits and vegetables, and freshwater fish, etc., were also discovered from these caves. The next important point is about Paleolithic ages. The Paleolithic human hunted collectively, and the stronger among them lead the group. There was no gender difference in hunting. The Paleolithic humans hunted collectively. The stronger among them lead the group. There was no gender difference in hunting. And they ate the flesh of hunted animals and carcass. What is the meaning of carcass? What is carcass? Carcass means dead body of animals. They ate, early humans ate the flesh of hunted animals and also the carcass. Then next point is, for hunting, they mainly used weapons made of stones. We already studied that they use stones as weapons, and they also used bones of animals, ivory, piece of wood, etc. as weapons. Okay. Then hide and bark were used as clothes. What is the meaning of hide? H-I-D-E, hide. Hide means animal skin. The early humans used hide and bark were as clothes. Then what is bark? Bark means marathuli. The next point is, the bones of animals were used as needles for sewing. This is about the Paleolithic age. Once again, the Paleolithic humans hunted collectively. The stronger among them lead the group. There was no gender difference in hunting, and they ate the flesh of hunted animals and carcass. For hunting, they mainly used weapons made of stones, and they also used bones of animals, ivory, piece of wood, etc. as weapons. And hide and bark were used as clothes. The last point is, bone of animals were